And just for now, there is a hereafter.
And heaven tonight includes the civil rights icon who is a blessing to our community and our nation.
One person is never to make everything right in this world, all of us together.
But no one person did more to bring us all together than the Reverend Fred Shuttlesworth.
Yeah, he fought to make the dream of civil rights a reality. And now News 5's Curtis Fuller is joining us with much more of his legacy tonight. Curtis?
Well, Jack and Cherie, Cincinnati is very much a part of that legacy. He first arrived here in town back in 1961. He was the pastor of two churches, his longest time spent at Greater New Light Baptist Church over in Avondale, more than 40 years there. Today, I talked to a few people who knew him best. They all called him friend.
We know that we all have to come to this day, and this is his time. And certainly, Cincinnati is a better place. Our country is a better place because he passed this way.
Paul Booth is the son of another civil rights giant, the late L.V. Booth. He talked to me about the special relationship his family has enjoyed with Fred Shuttlesworth.
Good friends. In fact, it was because of my father that Reverend Shuttlesworth came to Cincinnati.
Others like Reverend Damon Lynch Jr. called Shuttlesworth one of his closest friends.
He might not ever get a monument, but his life is a testament to his courage. He had more courage than anyone I've ever seen. He was bulldog tenacious.
Fred Shuttlesworth put his life on the line for more than 70 years fighting for the rights of others. He received hundreds of awards. A street in Avondale was named after him. But many still agree Cincinnati could never do enough to celebrate this American leader.
But I always felt about him that he had this sense of fairness, didn't show kind of jealousy and competitiveness in spite of all the great things that this man has done. So really quite a remarkable person.
Whenever you do work in this field, you look as who was the one who made you want to do it. And Fred always made me want to do more in civil rights.
This is certainly a message to Cincinnati that this giant that walked among us ought to get what he's entitled to.
Now, I talked to his family today. Funeral arrangements have not been finalized just yet. The funeral will likely take place in Birmingham. Cherie?